It just started to rain, so make this quick. Just picked up this, it's a hydro 52 inch SCAG water at an auction, and usually at this auction it'll tell you if there's a, like, if it says there's a problem, it's usually a problem, but if it doesn't say nothing, it's usually not a problem. So I assumed it ran, but this is all, like, everything's, all the covers are loose, all the bolts are missing. That's not looking too great. First thing I noticed when I picked it up was the starter was stuck. Let me just cover up. So, let's get this out of here. That's the first thing I noticed. And that could have just happened because the battery is weak. Because the first thing I did when I got home was check the battery, and it had zero. Nothing at all. So, got a battery right there. But so I'm going to pop the spark plug. Turn that. See what's going on with this starter. There's no gas in it. Everything's loose. So I already took the spark plugs out, and it's minimal movement. Took a little flywheel, the screen cover off, but it's really not moving that much, so about to back this out, starter out, and see how much that has to do with just. Over here somewhere. I'm gonna take that out. It's raining, so I'm trying to wrap this up. There's one bolt back here. Let's see what happened with this thing. Shattered and flew off. It's like the thing that actually, the pin that actually holds it up top, retaining clip, whatever. So now I can it's not seized. I had a little worry about it because at first I thought all this stuff was done by the people at the auction that were looking at it, just trying to figure out what's going on with it. Had a dead battery. Figured they might have cranked it until it got stuck. Then they try to remove parts because, like, all the covers are off. Bolts aren't here. You over here. All these covers are off. So I'm gonna work on seeing if I can repair that starter. I'm not sure if I have that one inside. So, need to swap it, repair the starter, and go from there. But I'm actually glad it was a stuck starter and nothing internal. The bolt in the back's tricky, so put that in first and then. Stupid cover. Now I gotta thread it. Cannot find my little stupid gear wrench thing, ratchet wrench. The best way to do this is just get it with your finger, thread in, and then you can get it from. So just use the ratchet. It's hard to just get this bolt in there and get it threaded. Stand over top of it with my two fingers and kind of just thread it in there with my fingertips. There is not really a good way to see that. Right in there. Was off. So it runs so far. So right now, $300, $35 starter. Move some of the stuff off. I want to see if the actual gears work. thought one side was a little weak, but maybe not. Choke at the stop, but eh. Come on. Shut the fuel off. They didn't want to shut off. I got it. Shut off. Manual pull, that's what I'm gonna do. I'll pull the damn choke myself. So, what am I at? $300 for the auction. There's a buyer fee and tax, so probably $340-ish for the mower, $35 for the starter. As of now, I don't see anything else wrong with it. Looks like I can throw the covers back on and start cutting with it. I'll test it on my yard first. The oil was a little low, so I started getting worried about this. You see how they even have these bolts off. They had everything off. So I was like, damn, did they take it apart to rebuild it and then find out? See a bit of smoke coming. That gas, it's like barely anything in the bottom of the tank. That's never good. So if I just dump the rest of that fuel out, put fresh fuel in it, see how long she'll hold up. For $300, you know, if I get a couple weeks out of her commercially, that works for me. It's a 52-inch hydro. SCAG.